everyone, it's Jen, and today I'm gonna show you how to make a trivet. The best part about our Stitchin' in the Kitchen designs is we take our quilt blocks and we've turned them into multiple projects, and this is just one of the many you're gonna learn today. So here I have all of the materials that I need for our trivet. We're gonna start with an 8x8 quilt block, and you're gonna start with some Insulbrite. If you're not sure what that is, it is just what it sounds like. It's insulation, because later on you're gonna use your trivet to put something hot as a pan or a hot plate on top of it. I'm gonna take my quilt block, lay it right on top of my Insulbrite, and I'm gonna use my quilt block as a template to cut out the Insulbrite so it's the same size as my quilt block. What I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna take my quilt block and my Insulbrite and I'm gonna lay it on my backing and binding fabric. So you can use this piece as both backing and binding. So take your quilt block and your Insulbrite and try to center it. You wanna make sure that you have 1.5 inches of fabric sticking out on each edge here, okay? So remember, that's 1.5 inches. Then what you're gonna do is make sure, we use some safety pins to pin all three of those layers in place so they're nice and secured together. Okay, so before we move on, after you pin all three layers in place, what you need to do is you're gonna take a ruler and you're gonna mark a 45 degree angle on the corner. You can see that it's just touching, I've marked that with that purple marker, it's just touching that tip. So you wanna make that 45 degree mark around the remaining three edges there. Now we're gonna move on. I'm gonna flip, I've gone ahead and already flipped this over, and what you're gonna do, I need to find my marker. There we go, okay. So once you flipped it over, you're gonna fold it back, right sides together. It's gonna fold back just like this. Put your edges together, and you see your marker right here, and I'm just gonna take a pin, and I'm gonna pin right where that marker stops here, because that's gonna tell me where I need to stitch. And I'm gonna do that to all four of my corners. Once all four of my corners are marked like this, folded back, and then pinned into place, I can go ahead and stitch right along that marked line. Now again, I've done mine in purple, so it was easier for you to see it. You might be using another color. But just keep in mind, you just need to stitch right along this line. All right, so next I have all those lines stitched already. You can see them. It's a little bit difficult because I have white thread here, but they've already been stitched into place. Now once they're stitched, you have all this excess fabric. We want to get rid of that because it's going to make it a lot easier to flip that binding around to the front. So what you need to do is leave only 1/4 inch. So if I just trim this like that, I've left 1/4 inch of fabric, and I've already done that on this side, okay? So you're gonna have to do that on all four sides. I'm not gonna do it on mine here, but just remember, you're definitely gonna need to trim all four corners of yours. Then I'm gonna flip my quilt block back over, and then I can flip my binding and my backing. And you'll see that once I flip it, I push that corner out just using my finger, it flips perfectly, everything folds nicely. Watch what happens though if I left all this fabric, it gets really bulky, really bunches up. It's hard to flip it. It doesn't look as nice. It's not as nice and crisp as this corner is. So really make sure that you're clipping that excess fabric. Once you have clipped and folded over to the front, you can just go ahead and pin along all four edges, and that's what I'll show you next, okay? So all of my binding has been flipped over to the front. I've gone ahead and I've pinned those in place. And now we're gonna attach the binding by just running a top stitch along all four edges here. And when you're done, your trivet will look something like this, and we have multiple designs for you to make lots of trivets for all your hot plates.